Hello friends, story time today from Sudhamurthy's book, The Magic Drum and Other Favorite Stories. The Golden Silence.
Somesh was a boy of 10. He was a chatterbox and loved to talk to anyone who had time to listen to him. Sometimes he would talk so much that his parents would have to tell him to stop and rest his tongue a while. Every night he would lie down to sleep with his father, who would tell him a story. At that time, Somesh was all ears. He would listen to his father's story attentively and then drift off to sleep. One day, he listened to his father's story as usual. The next morning when he woke up, his parents were shocked. There was a pin drop silence in the house. Somesh had stopped talking. At first they were relieved, thinking he was playing a game. But when he did not talk, even after many days, they got worried. They took him to the best medicine man in the country, to all the sages and holy men they could find. But no one found anything wrong with him. Neither did any of the treatments have any effect on the boy. Years passed and Somesh grew into a young man. His parents and everyone who knew him now thought him to be dumb. One day he was traveling with his father's friend Lokesh to another village. They sat down to rest under a huge banyan tree. A crow was cawing loudly on one of the branches. Lokesh was telling Somesh a very funny story involving a milkman, his cow, and the village gunda, and was mighty irritated to have a crow cawing loudly overhead as he spoke. Finally, he could take it no longer. The crow was spoiling a perfect story. He first tried to shoo it away, but it paid him no heed. Then he picked up a stone and threw it at the crow, thinking that would make it fly away. Instead, the stone hit the crow and it fell dead. Lokesh was horrified. He had not meant to kill a bird at all. As he stood staring at the dead form lying under the tree, he did not realize when Somesh had come up behind him. He was stunned when he heard a voice behind him say, "Foolish crow, if only you had kept your mouth shut and been silent, you would not have met this end." Lokesh forgot all about the crow and turned to stare at Somesh. The boy had spoken. "Say it again, Somesh," he begged. But Somesh just smiled mysteriously and refused to utter one more word. Lokesh hurried back to the village and told Somesh's father the story. Now Somesh's parents begged him again and again, "Speak once more, son, for the sake of your dear old parents." But it seemed as if Somesh did not know how to talk. Everyone put the incident down to Lokesh's imagination. After that day, Somesh's father and Lokesh, who had been business partners and friends for many years, stopped speaking to each other. They took on other partners in business and suffered losses. They were miserable as they had no one to share their deepest sorrow and joys with. Somesh saw all this, and one day as he sat down to eat with his father, he noticed his father was just toying with his food. His mind was clearly toying, means not paying attention, playing with his food, not eating properly. His mind was clearly elsewhere. Suddenly, Somesh spoke again. "If Lokesh's uncle had remained silent, he would have been your best friend still." "You were right, father. Silence is golden and speech is silver." His father nearly fainted when he heard this. He suddenly remembered the bedtime. bedtime story he had told him, then told his 10-year-old son. It was about a king who lost his kingdom because he was too busy talking to prepare for war. And his final words before his son had drifted off to sleep were, "Silence is golden, speech is silver." He hugged his son and explained, "That was just a saying. How I have longed to hear you talk again. Please do not do this again. I will never complain about your chattering again." From that day on, Sumit spoke again, but he remembered to think carefully before he opened his mouth. End of story. Hope you enjoyed. Bye. Till next time.